What it do, y'all, and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I am so excited to bring you guys an update on my project pan. This one is specifically my beauty project pan, where I have quite a few non-makeup items rolling throughout the year, where I'm just trying to get use out of things that have kind of been collecting dust in my collection, or I have been collecting for an unknown reason. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I have been attempting to update this particular project every month. If memory serves me correctly, last month I unfortunately just did not have the time to do so. So this is kind of about 2 months, maybe a month and a half of difference in of use. So that will be seen significantly, because I do have actually quite a few empties or kind of finished products in this update. But with that said, let's just dive on in. I typically try to start off with my body lotions, just because that's kind of the steps that I take when I'm actually putting on fragrant products. I have definitely gotten more use out of both of my lotions throughout this last month. I'm getting more comfortable at my current job, and you know, although yes, I will still get nice compliments on my lotion, I don't find that it attracts or kind of impedes my job. So I've been happy with just sticking with the lotions, and then I'll put on a perfume or a spray or something when I get home to kind of start the winding down process, and just for my personal enjoyment. So for my day lotion, it was the Golden Mango Lagoon scent. This has notes of sunny mango, saltwater wood, and coral bloom. I am unfortunately sad to say that I did finish this. I'm happy that I finished it, but this was such a good scent. All of the scents that I've kept in my collection post my declutter are really favorites, so it is kind of sad in a way to see them gone, but at the same time, I did spend my money and I do want to go ahead and finish them. If you are a Bath & Body Works girly and you do actually kind of collect and or hoard products, I do just want to let you know that apparently there is about a 2-year kind of limit on their body creams and lotions. I don't think I've heard anybody say there's any form of like shelf life, if you will, on any of their other products, but those are products that I've heard there is truly a shelf life. So do keep that in mind in the event that it's something that you do hoard or collect. The other body cream that I had in this project was Sweater Weather, and I'm really happy I put this in this project. Originally, I had kept this because this was a scent that I absolutely loved, specifically in the mist or the body spray, and I got the cream because I kind of wanted a full set, if you will. But in using this so many times to get through this product, I found that I did not like this scent in the cream. So I'm really happy I got through it. This has notes of Suncrisp Apple, autumn leaves, and orchid woods. And I think it was the woods that just was too heavy on my nose. It started to smell very masculine, which is not a bad thing at all. I have plenty of masculine scents. You'll even see my new night cream is a more masculine scent, but there was just something about that one I just personally was not attracted to and I didn't enjoy. But I am happy to have finished that product, and you know, my body was moisturized for umpteen months because of that product. Now, if you have not seen these projects, I do typically add additional products in because this is very much a rolling project. I really want to just get use out of a lot of these products that are in these kind of particular nuanced categories in my collection. So since my previous video, I have already needed to roll products in, specifically in the creams. As I said, both of those creams are finished. So the first cream that I rolled in is Fresh Jungle Rain, and this has honestly been hitting perfectly the last about week or so in my area. We have seen a lot of rain, even though we've seen really hot temperatures as well. It's just been a very weird kind of beginning of summer. So the notes on this one are rain-kissed palms, Amazon dragon fruit, and misty breeze. I do believe in this scent that they have a base of vanilla in there. So throughout my day, that's pretty much the main thing that I smell. Although there is a deeper kind of woodiness that does also come off of my skin towards the very end of my workday. So this has been really, really nice. I've really enjoyed it. Once again, I have gotten compliments, but it's not been so kind of, my scent bubble from that scent has not been so appalling that it has disrupted anybody's job or work at my job. And then for the night cream, I rolled in Leather and Brandy. Honestly, I rolled this in because I couldn't remember the smell and I didn't have any form of attachment. And if we're being honest, I've been kind of avoiding some of the creams that I have a little bit more of an attachment with because I really want to kind of savor those just a little bit more. So this is one of the scents that I do believe they came out in the like men's collection or like that unisex collection that they unfortunately pretty much discontinued within that same season. And the notes here are a deep fragrance with a hint of spice. And this is inspired by the comfort of leather chair and a warmth of brandy. I think that this is quite masculine presenting. I don't have an issue with this though, so this is something that I am comfortable wearing at night. I haven't needed to use this as much, and honestly, night creams as per usual, specifically with that sweater weather, I've just kind of gotten out of the rhythm of reaching for them. But as you could see, I definitely already have a dent on that fresh jungle rain because I'm still in the routine of like reaching for a cream to moisturize my body during the day. So of course, as per usual, my goal for both of these products is to have them done by my next update, which if I actually do it within the next month, then hopefully by next month. Otherwise, no big deal. It will continue to stay in the project until it is done. Then next, usually what I like to talk about are my travel sample or travel size perfumes. I have three still left in this project and I was targeting one mainly. So let's get into that one. And that is Tangerine Boy. She is also empty. This is a beautiful kind of citrusy scent. It does have a slight kind of muskiness to it, which I find allows you to have like a really nice sillage with this particular scent. It's a really nice scent. Don't get me wrong. Is it something that I think I'm gonna like run out to get full bottle of? No, but I'm happy I finished it. And what I will do, as I have been doing with a lot of my travel size perfumes, is that I just keep the bottles. And if I do end up picking up the full size, I have a travel size that I can travel with. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do with that particular scent. The other two travel size sprays, honestly, I haven't really been focusing on because the Tangerine I really only use during the weekends. And unfortunately, this one that I'm about to talk about next, I actually put back away in my perfume collection. I completely forgot that this was in the project. So this will be done by the next update. And this is Ellis Brooklyn's Sun Fruit. This is the perfect scent for like this beginning of summer. It's a bright citrusy scent. I really do enjoy this one. It was just kind of, I wanted to get through the travel before I bought a full size. At the point of me in my kind of perfume collection now, I'm not as positive that I'm actually going to go ahead and pick up a full size, but I do still want to go ahead and get through that particular scent. And then again, another scent that I truly just have not reached for is, of course, Coco Musk. It's here. This is the one product from this whole project that I think is just truly going to be haunting me all year, along with one other. I'm just, you know, I really don't reach for it, which is why I put it here, and I'm still not reaching for it. One product that I did forget to talk about is my body mist, and I have one in this project, and this is Cozy Evening from Bath & Body Works. Now, to be quite honest, I don't think I've reached for this since the last update, which is quite appalling seeing as the last update was about 2 months ago, but this is just where I'm at. I mean, I'm pretty much comfortable with just wearing the lotion to bed if I wear a lotion to bed. But what I aim to do now that I actually have a nightstand is I'm gonna put this on my nightstand. That will trigger me to remember to at minimum use this as a bed kind of fragrance where I will literally spray my bed and just get my use out of this. I just want to get the use out of this and continue to get through some of these fragrance mists, because otherwise Honestly, I might just get rid of the whole collection because I'm really not reaching for them over my perfumes. I just prefer my perfumes for my day-to-day activities. Now, I have three full bottle perfumes that I had in this project, and let's go from day to night as I've been doing with everything else. The one day perfume, once again, I think I will definitely be targeting a lot more in these next couple of months is Marc Jacobs Daisy Ever So Fresh. This is a beautiful, fresh, citrusy scent, as the name suggests. This is another scent that, like, if I was back in my more office job, I would really feel comfortable tying these two together, and I would have a significantly deeper dent in this. But once again, because I am in more of a medical field job, it's just not appropriate, in my opinion, to have too much scent on me. So this is definitely something that I will hope to get more use out of during the weekends and days that I have off. But until then, this is just going to be very slow going, and I am personally okay with that. I do want to get through a decent amount of perfumes this year, but I am also okay with the slow progress, just because of, how my life is right about now. The other scent that is another kind of slow progress, although there is going to be a new slash created after this last period, so I'm happy about that, is Skylar's Honeysuckle Dream. I've said it once and I will say it again. This is just a little too sharp on my nose lately. So even when I do reach for this, I reach for it quite literally right before I jump into bed, so I don't have to necessarily smell it. It just kind of, you know what I mean? Maybe not. Either way, this is not something that I'm repurchasing at all. And yes, I could definitely like give it to somebody else, and I'm sure they would get use out of it. Even Mama Bear, I'm sure she'd get a lot of use out of this, but for now, it's in my project, so I'm gonna keep it, and hopefully I will get through that before the end of this year. And then the last scent that I have is the one that I actually finished. So this is Penrose's Secret Garden, and this was a very interesting scent. So this had like white chocolate. I think this had caramel and some form of vanilla, maybe tonka bean in this one. Either way, I was actually thoroughly surprised. I want to say I was going and reaching for this yesterday at night, or maybe a couple of days ago. Regardless, I reached for this to, spray on my body, and I was confused why I wasn't getting any juice. And I put this up towards the light because that's the only way I can really see like the line of juice, and it's done. There's absolutely no product in here. I sprayed all of it, and I'm so happy. I'm very happy with that progress. And I think now that, like, this one, which was my kind of main perfume, is out of this project, I think I will be able to get more use out of the Honeysuckle and the Good Evening or Cozy Evening, just because I don't have any other kind of night scent to really reach for. And I did forget one full bottle, so let me go ahead and talk about this one really quickly. And this is Flower Bomb's Ruby Orchid. And I got a little bit of use out of this since my last dash. Once again, this is a scent that I will only reach for on the weekends. This is just way too strong for me to wear to work. If I really wanted to wear a perfume to work, and I wanted to stick with the perfumes in this collection or in this project, it would definitely have to be this. This is just absolutely way too strong for work, at least once again at my current job in the medical field. So that is that, and I will continue to hopefully chug away slowly on that scent as well. So yeah, that is the update. Honestly, I'm very happy with the amount of empties that I have on record for this video. I have four empties that I have done, and honestly, I only replaced the two creams. I'm not going to be replacing either of these two perfumes, just because, like I said, I kind of want to work on some more that I have already here. And then once I have done that and kind of completely finished out those respective categories, that's probably when I'll go ahead and refresh those respective categories. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Of course, give it a huge thumbs up if you did. If you're interested in seeing more Project Panning content from me this year, I have quite a few Project Pans that I am participating in, and I will have my Project Pan playlist down below. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.